Audible? Clear? Good. So, please spare some 5 minutes time extra for me, okay? For your after break, right? So, the thing is, so how was the day? Like, till now, we had some really good technical session and really fun Kinect hacks. So, it's been fun? Was it? Okay, don't make the session really. I'm a crazy chap, I'm really cool, so can you hit on me anytime? Now? Okay. So, so it's been fun. Till now, this is my first time in RoidCon, and I've come all over from Chennai. And so, I'd like to start off. This session is completely about design. So, I think I'm seeing good crowds over here. So, Android has not been much played a good part in design. So, we'll see some of the what of the things that have come up with the latest design implements that have come. So, I would like to start with a small story that I had that I recently encountered. So, how many of you have brothers, like younger, elder? Can I see some hands? So, how many of you guys don't fight? Oh, that's very so. That's a huge rivalry between your brothers, right? So it happens like so the same thing. I had the same problem in my home. Me and my brother don't go much. So what happened is one day he came to me and said, "Listen, is your Gmail password your phone number?" And I was like, "What?" And no. Then he said he gave a staring look and then he again said, Is your Gmail password the reverse of your phone number?" I said, "Dude, no. Can you stop it right there?" And I gave a sarcastic look and I just moved out calmly. And he also moved out calmly inside his room. So we just locked our rooms. Then it's the most frantic time that I should jump into my laptop and change my Gmail password, right? That hyper reactions that was going on. So I would so the problem is my brother just needs to log into my Gmail account. Oops. And I should go into my Gmail account and then change the password. So Gmail has a small design flaw that I encountered, and so we'll go through those steps. So let's see. So what are the design? I mean, the steps that you need to do to change your password. So step one, you navigate to that settings button over the corner. Then go to settings, then go to accounts there, and then move to in the accounts tab. Then you have Google account settings, then you go to security, then from there you move to password management, and from there change password, and finally I have the change password screen. These are every screens and I have taken a small bit of the screenshot. So by the time that I went all these screens and I changed my Gmail password, he gave me this look, and like after I get inside the room, and that was his staring look. Okay, so so constructive design for Android, that's the topic for today. It's going to be fun, so loosen out yourself, and it's all about design. Design is good, design is cool. So a little bit about me. I'm Wesley, Isaac John Wesley, pretty long name. So I spent a lot of time in Photoshop. I've been a designer for a very long time, from the age of 12. Recently I got into Android developing. I have no idea about Java for about a year back. Then learned it in a really hard way. And quite now I'm developing a somewhat a handsome app with my design skills. So I spend a lot of time in Android. I love HTML5 and Stack Overflow. I spend a lot of time in Stack Overflow. And I'm a dribbler too, so I dribble a lot. And that community is really cool, so you guys should check it out. So right now, technically, I'm a chief product designer of ValetKit. Some recently news that we got funded by 500 startups, right? So that was a big day for us. So constructive design for Android. So the topic is very simple. It's like hit to the point. So Wiki says that saving a useful purpose, tending to build up. So it's a quite straightforward thing, but constructive is like constructions, right? So like building blocks and pipes and the electrical systems. Like, so In design also, so everything is construction. So like you, every element in design is not made like one night and ported it in the next day. So it's not, I won't say that you can't make a really, it's very difficult to make a handsome looking app in a hack night. So that's there, right? So it's a minimal viable product that you can make is work on the core interesting part of it. So we'll see about the agenda. So by the end of the day, we'll see about what is focus, what does focus has to do with design. We'll see about what you should observe when designing. Okay, these are all completely for Android, nothing with HTML or iPhone or anything. Okay, so we'll see about how to tell a story. Every apps has a story. If you make that story well promising and short and simple, then your app is the next big thing. So then you have, we'll get a little technical here. We'll get how to work with flexible designs, like Android has this huge desk of all the device sizes, right? So we'll check on how we can do that. Then we'll see some of the design patterns that are released recently with a lot of enhancements that have been going up after Ice Cream Sandwich and Jelly Bean. So then we would wrap it up for questions. I'm very much interested in that part. So this the code is simple, okay? I like this code. Max is very easy and design is really hard. So so if design fails, there's a problem that everything collapses. Anyone hitting on your app will say, wow. They will not say that, wow, the code that you have written is too good, man. They will say always like, wow, the design is awesome and pakka and everything. So let's get to the thing. And great design is to put focus on where it matters. So focus is like a very important stuff in designing for mobile apps. So we'll see what focus is. So I would like to guys take back to the screen and just check out this painting about on Mona Lisa. So just observe it for like 5 seconds right now. So when you observe it, you'll be looking at certain elements in the painting, right? So then I will take you a little back, zoom out, and see now your observation on certain elements will little deviate, and you will start observing the other elements that are there in this painting. Then again I take it even more back, and then you get deviated, lot of distractions, lot of way places to see. So what did you observe when the image was like perfectly zoomed? So the thing is, we tend to look at any painting, we tend to look at the eyes. The eyes is the most important part. I'm basically an artist, so this is like all art related theoretical stuff. So the eyes is the most important part that you will be focusing on. So we'll see what this is actually the visual perception, that whenever we see something, where is our eyes getting? So that's the so what is visual perception had to do with Android and design? So there's a lot of things that matters in mobile design for visual perception. We'll see what we'll take it to the apps, and we'll see what apps have done this in a really great way. So good example, Path. How many of you like Path, the design? Wow, good hands. So whenever you use Path, or when you saw it for the first time, and when you logged in, it was like, I really love Path, the way that they have designed it. But where did you focus when you start? So the focus is on the cover image that's there. So your first look at that, and you get, wow, I can read a person in just 2 seconds with that cover image, right? Then the focus changed to the navigations, that's the logo, and the what all the things that you can do with Path. So this is another app, AnyDo, a very good productive app. So AnyDo, the first thing that you focus is the typing place where you put the task, you type the task in. Then this is not an Android app, this is a circle, Clear. So Clear is like a very design intuitive app, and it's more to do with heat maps, and their psychology of treating the to-do list is very different. So you see, you tend to see the first, the strongest, the heat part of, and then, I mean the top part of it first, and then you gradually move on. So design is actually building it for simple. One of my favorite device. So everything should be very simple. Make your apps very, very, very minimalistic, but convey what you wanted to convey. That's the key factor that you need to do when designing for apps. And so actually the process is like this. Your art, all your artworks, combined with your technological and the ideas and your code and everything. And you have the users. So when you build a strong connection between what you wanted to convey and what has reached the users, then you have succeeded in your app. Take it a very simple app, very minimalistic app, and just put in the ideas and just put a strong design on it, and it would go viral. So that's the key thing that I want to focus on. So this is a secret over here. Hide the complicated stuff. No, Apple would not market this view of the device, right? So the complicated stuff are there, even in the mobile app, but hide it. Put it in a slide viewer or put it in a settings page or somewhere, okay? So simple is hard. Designing for the simplest, making it very simple is the hardest part, okay? Trust me. So the key factor is always look to minimalize what you have. Eliminate the stuff. I mean, what I wanted to say here is like, what you already developed is the most complicated thing right now, okay? You would have thought, oh, there is a swipe view, there is a tab view, and can we have this view pager, and lot of things that you planned it, and you put everything, okay, you code well and do it everything. But when it comes to design, everything is complication, okay? Remove all those complications and yet convey the same idea that you wanted to convey. That's the most simplest app, and that's the most you have done. You have achieved a lot in that. So this is a small example where there is a lot of complications in one app, and there are a lot of this is paper mill. There's a so that's a beautiful app that's available for Android. So lot of these navigations can be actually minimalized with those three tabs, right? So that's a key factor that you should know about designing. So observe. We'll get to how we should observe for what we need to tell to the audience. So the thing is, so this is a small quote that Henry Ford, I thought he may or may not have said, but the thing is, he observed what people thought about when he made cars, right? So that's the observation that I'm trying to say. That's the observation that you need to build. So look for what the user wants, and look for what you want the user to know about when they use the app, and what do you expect from the user. So have these three steps, and like if you're making an app for babies, you should be targeting moms and parents, right? So give it the parents and check whether what do they whether is it easy for them to analyze what I mean to use this app as easy as possible. And registration is the most important thing. It's not about the first 5 seconds that they use the app. After they close the app, whether will the app again open it, and will they still remember how to work on the app? That's the most important stuff you need to observe. So one of my favorite quote, impact matters more than impression. It's not about being so pixel perfect. I mean, you can be, but it's about the impact that you create on this on the first few seconds that the user opens the app. So I'll quickly run up to. There's a lot of slides to be shown. So how many of you like this phone? I mean, use this phone. Wow. So how many of the you? Everyone would have loved texting in that phone. No, nothing can be beaten out of that phone. That it's very fast to text, just because it's very easy. I mean, the design of it is very simple. You have that C button, right? That saved a lot of lives. Like you can clear it in a can text it really fast and you can clear all the things if you want, edit it and a lot of stuff. So a few stats about this phone, when it launched, it went really viral. So this was a 200 million sales in 2003, and yes, that matters a lot in comparing to 100 million iPods and 115 million PS2s. So that's the impact that design creates over anything that you do. So next thing is to tell a story. How you need to come up with a story to tell, complete to do in the apps itself. So we'll see about Instagram story. So Instagram had this. It's very simple, like 1, 2, 3 steps. That's what I'm talking about story. Like you have every app should be minimalized to 3 steps, and that's where you create a big impact on the apps. So this is Instagram story: open, capture, add filters, and then upload. As simple as that. Everything is next, right? Followers and explore. Those are all the coolness factors that you create in the app. So this is Foursquare stories. Foursquare story: open and locate, and then check in. So as simple as that, that has made the app viral. So we'll get a little technical, flexible design. So people say it's like all fragmented, dude, I can't be designing for all these screens, how can I? And it's like your company's, your boss will be too busy about, and why this not working in this screen and why not in that? So people say that fragmentation is future. That's been the normal, common thing that's been hanging around. Like, dude, that's the next future that we need to get prepared of. No, it's not. Fragmentation is past, present, and future. It's been in the past. You have seen fragmented desktop apps. Like when you create a desktop apps, you have different screens that you need to optimize. And so from that age itself, the fragmentation is there, and you need to be clever enough to adapt it to Android. So think like a web designer, how you design. We all jumped from web to mobile, right? So think like the same concept and the same perspective, and design for Android. So some of the layouts, most of you would have known this: relative layout, linear layouts, and frame layouts. Relative layout, stretching part, and when you give fill width and fill parent. So it handles. So what I'm trying to say is Android handles most of the parts that you have problem with, the fragmentation. So the device resolution. So it's just that you need to use your common sense to use certain layouts that will work. So this encapsulation, it's a little technical, that there is some element that you can encapsulate anywhere when the design changes, when the device changes. There's one thing that you can check it out. It's like constructing, it's like Lego blocks, put together. Construct an app like that. Don't think like construct it for one screen alone. So it keeps on. When you construct it this way, it's more easy to replicate on bigger screens. So single plane layouts and multi-plane layouts. These are some of the layouts that Android has for the latest things, latest release. So some of the design patterns, how navigation works, you'll see. So navigation is like recently they have like screen-to-screen navigation where you can slide and it goes to the next screen. So these are the elements that you can use to make a beautiful, handsome app. So tab navigation, you have those tabs on top, and you can navigate to the most 3 elements or the 4 elements that are there in the app. Then you have drill down navigation, like Flipboard, right? So you click on it, go deeper, and then you come out back. So up versus back, there's a problem. There's a problem that I've been evolving with Android developers. What is up and what is back? So up is like moving to the first screen of the app. I have it as simple as that. Back is like moving to the child screens. The parent opens the child opens another child. So moving back in a phase. So this is a small representation of how it works. So action bar, you must have known. So these are the elements that are there in the action bar. And then you have multiple action bar, an action bar on the top, and action bar on the bottom. That's there. So You have contextual bars. This is like when you click on, I mean, say, click on a list item and you click on it for a longer time, and this opens up on top. It works in Gmail and for a few apps like that. So tabs in action bar. Tabs can, it might not be below the action bar. It can be on the action bar itself. This works with good with tablets. So then spinners in action bar. Like your app needs to change the values alone in the app, so you use spinners. Then you have action overflow. Action overflow, I wanted to cover this screen. So it's not a replication. I mean, it's not, you had the menus before, but it's not equal to the action bars right now. So action bars is like if the action bar has, I mean, overflow is like if the action bar has a lot of icons. If it's a smaller screen, it will show you that three dots alone where you can navigate. If it's a larger screen, it can show you all the icons. So that's the idea behind it. And swipe use. So preparing the assets, always prepare the highest asset, the highest pixel enough. I mean, so and reduce it for the different size. Don't just scale it down. It looks really crappy. Get to Photoshop. Make it little more the pixel. Make the pixel perfection little more for the smaller screens. So I'm gonna finish. Good versus bad. This is my last slide. So this was there in the last version of Android 2.3, and those like you have all these buttons, big buttons in the app, and now it's like all minimalized. It's very simple and intuitive. So this is one another example, and then some random infos. So I'm getting over with it. So impact matters more than impression. Design is not about products; it's about people. And think about communication than decoration. How you communicate with your user, that's the most important thing that you need to know. Don't hesitate to steal. Go to Dribbble and steal all those chota chota elements in there, like little things. So, and to become a designer is a little hard, but to be a design thinker, it's like really easy. Entrepreneurs, hackers can become design thinkers. You need just the common sense. And there's a lot of random infos, links. So you can scan this QR code if you want. The whole presentation is there. So that's it. That's the end of it. Anything, questions? I'm sorry, I have to rush up really fast. Go home.
Yeah, we went a bit over on this session, but luckily we have a break right after. We can spend a few minutes doing Q&A. We're going to break for about 30 minutes after this and resume at 4 o'clock. I'm just going to say this one more time as a reminder. We've handed out feedback forms. We'd love to have them back with your feedback before you leave today. You can drop them off in a basket that's going to be by the registration desk. Also, if you're leaving today and not coming back tomorrow, please make sure you drop the NFC cards that are in your badges into the same basket where the feedback forms go. And also, do not forget to bring your badges with you tomorrow when you come back. Thanks. And we can take some questions now.
Yeah. Any questions? Okay. A lot of links. So these are some of the places where I get inspiration. Yeah, question.
Hi. You know, talking to designers and engineers as building, while I go through the motions of building an app, everybody talks about sticking to the guidelines provided by iOS or Android and so on.
Yeah.
My question was, how do you differentiate yourself if everybody's just going to stick to guidelines?
Differentiate between iOS and Android?
No, between any app that you, let's say if we take Android as the platform, if every designer is going to just follow the guidelines provided by Android as a platform,
yeah.
How will you differentiate your user experience?
Okay, the question was very simple. So the thing is, first practice the guidelines that they're giving, okay? Then this is out of my experience, okay? Then that's where you tend to think that, okay, can we make this even more better? Why is Android very flat? That's been like a lot of questions that I'm getting right now. Why is it so flat? Just make it more bulging and more interactive and more the gradations. Work on it, but remember the patterns. The patterns are very important when it differs from different devices. Okay, so have the consistent pattern. I mean, work on the patterns, but I'm not telling you to stick to a design as such. Okay. Any more? One at the back. Twitter handle. Okay. Yeah, you can ask your question.
How important is choosing of colors to you, like a theme or minimalistic?
How important is choosing a color?
Colors. Generally, when you're creating an app, do you stick to a theme or how do you select the colors? Do they have to be light or, you can't keep using all the colors.
Okay. It's a bad idea to use all the colors. From my experience, stick with pastel colors. Like, don't go to the brightest red and the brightest blue, because the device actually drains a lot of battery with a lot of bright colors. Okay, so that's a problem there. And it mostly depends upon the app. So if you're making a video related app, it can be dark, because videos tend to look good in dark environments. So that's a theme that I would prefer in that. And any more? Yeah, here.
Basically, when we have some apps already, right, which are not so nice in design, and we are doing it again, redesigning and all that. So what happens, those ugly looking apps are already used by the users and they are used to it. Now when we come to do it redesigning, so how to take care of the dilemma that so that users don't get distracted that it's something new totally, drastically, but still we give a better user experience.
Okay. So the answer is like, so you already have a certain number of traction in your apps. Okay. And check on the traction level and what the user says, whether you get the comments that in the Android market and what the user didn't like or what the user didn't understand in the app. This is a problem with UI and UX. Okay, so UI can be changed, but the UX is the most critical part that should not be changed. If you are getting a good traction amount and if the curve is like going really good, okay, because the users are getting more interested to your app and they are again and again opening the app. But UI, have it like a 3 months gap change. Okay. Work on the lot of bugs fixes between that, and leave it for the major 2.0 release, saying that the UI has been enhanced. Okay, user point of view will completely change. Like, wow, they are really improvising on this app. So that's the psychology of users that I have been researching right now, and that's the answer to that. So I hope. One last question. Yeah, that. You can get offline. This whole discussion.
Hi. How do you observe customers? Like you mentioned in your presentation, that's one of the big aspects. So, like, how do you observe customers? Like, one of the strategies or methodologies that have been pretty common is to call customers in your get that tested, like your application or your site. So, is there anything that you can share on that, or strategies to do customer testing in labs, like?
Okay, you mean observing customers technically, like whether it's these UX and are working in the app or?
No, basically from design aspect, like whether they are able to understand like your button, instead of adding add, you're using a plus, whether they are able to identify those nuances, right? You do those customer testing.
One more time.
I mean from the design aspect, not from the technical aspect. So, okay. Like, how do you observe customers?
Okay, so observing is more like it's like you are the stage. Performance artist in the stage. Okay, you are giving it to the 300 audience right now. Okay, so what your dream about the app is actually matters in everything. Okay, the design, the technology behind it, and everything. Look for people who can actually test it. Don't give it to your hackers or your age level people. Give it to ages of all ages. I will tell you a small example. A few days back, a 4-year kid can understand Angry Birds. I mean, sorry, a 3-year-old kid can understand Angry Birds. The few seconds that you play, they get registered that this is how the UX is and this is how you have to fling and use it. So that's the success behind everything, observe it to a little community. Some people who were asking about in the morning session whether to release it for a final release and then change the UX, and it becomes a hard thing about what people will think. Like some people may like or some people may not like, you can't get into. So what I will say is release it for a very specific set of users that you are targeting on, and check their inputs. So I would say iOS is doing a really good job in this. It's like the early adopters are actually in the iOS development. So use that kind of an idea, sell it to the little, your known specific people, and then do it.
I have follow-up questions. I'll basically take it offline.
Sure. A lot of questions. Thank you.